Hi everyone, my name is Piotr Sawicki. I would like to tell you what would happen when e-commerce goes offline. But before that, I would just say a few words about me and the company I work at. I'm a customer success manager at Centuria, a company that has more than 10 years of experience in dedicated hosting solutions and IT infrastructure management. And a few months ago, we've decided that we'll go for specialize in a dedicated Magento stack, both on the hardware and the software side, that will be optimized for Magento to run as smoothly as possible. And since we have this part behind us, I would like to ask you a question. What would happen if suddenly one day you've lost all your data? And I would like all of you to seriously think about it. I think we would all agree that data loss is one of the biggest threats for almost every company. And unfortunately, it can happen at any time. You cannot predict it. If you could, then it wouldn't be such a threat anymore. So that's the worst thing in data loss. I've created a small map of technologies that are connected to your Magento and make your Magento run. Those are not all of them. That's, I think, some of the most important ones. And from the start, Magento is a software. There's some payment system that is connected to it. It runs on the server that is administrated and managed by some admin guys. It is connected to the internet via switches, routers, the internet solutions provider. And in the internet, there are users and hackers that are accessing your website. There's also a huge part on the bottom. It is the part of the data center infrastructure that helps your server run, and those are the power supply, the cooling system, the fire protection system. Mm-hmm. I've chose a few of those technologies to show you that all of them can fail and can force a huge data loss for you. And for the start, Magento is a software, and you surely know that software can be good or bad. The code can be so badly written that can cause a data loss. And you can find many posts on some forums, boards, that say that people lost data because of the bad software. And I found a case of a hotel in Mexico, and it was connected to a hotel room booking website. And the software of this hotel booking website was so bad that they couldn't sell any rooms. Because it was shown on the website that they are busy all the time, and they didn't see it because no one was going to their hotel. The other thing is the server, and the server is run by administrators. And administrators are also people. They can make mistakes. They can bribe or threaten to destroy your data. And I think many of the Polish people that are in this room remember the case from the March 2016, when there was a big, big downtime in a Polish hosting company. Someone with administrator privileges broke into their infrastructure and erased everything, including backups. There were more than 10 days of downtime, and finally, when they managed to recover backups, it turned out that they were more than 1 year old, so their customers lost more than 1 year of their work. And I don't think they have any customers right now. The other things are hackers that are somewhere over the internet, and they can at any time break into your infrastructure and cause a big, big damage to it. And unfortunately, we cannot protect ourselves against hackers. There are a few weeks ago, I guess there was an information that Russian hackers broke into the NSA infrastructure. If NSA can protect themselves, then I think any infrastructure is breakable. And a small example of it, there was in July 2016, there was a hacker attack on a big Polish internet service provider, and their customer data was stolen, it was leaked, and they couldn't protect themselves. And as I mentioned before, there's a whole data center infrastructure part of infrastructure that helps your servers run. And for the start, your servers can be harmed by fire. Like it happened in 2015 in Ghana. There was a fire going down in the nearby building, and it went on to the building where the data center was, and it destroyed the power room of the data center. And the whole nation suffered from the 4G network not working in the whole country because one data center was put on fire. You'd say that's not a problem because we have a fire protection system. But some of you may know that in data centers the fire is not fought by water, but there's a special gas called inertia that has a very low percentage of oxygen in it. And since there's no oxygen, there's no fire. But when the gas is dumped, there's a very big pressure change and a very huge noise that can destroy the disks of the servers. Like it was a few weeks ago in a big bank's data center in Bucharest, in Romania, where there was some fire protection system test going on. They dumped the gas and it destroyed some of their infrastructure, including disks. And the whole bank suffered for more than 10 hours of downtime because of just tests. There was no fire at all, it was just tests. What is more, when there's a big bunch of servers, they generate much heat. And that's why the cooling systems are used in data centers. But every system can fail, and as well as cooling system, it also can fail. Like in 2013, in an American university data center, there were two cooling systems, redundant cooling system, and they were switching to each other from time to time. And one of them didn't work after the switch. They tried to switch back, and the other one also didn't work. There was an overheating, and it resulted in them losing their data from their hard drives. Servers won't work without power supply. It's needed for them to work. And there's also a possibility that power supply would not work, would be cut off. Like in a data center of a big American airline company in 2016, when there was a power outage, and for a day or so, all the flights were delayed. No plane could land or start because of this power outage. You say that's not a problem because we have power generators. But power generators can, for example, explode. Like in American data center in 2008, where there was a huge explosion of the power generator. It took place in Houston, and it put their whole building on fire, and more than 9,000 servers suffered for a long downtime because of this explosion. There's also a UPS system that should keep your infrastructure running, but it can fail as well. It was a bad deal for American airline companies because another company had power outage as well, and the UPS system did not go on. And they also suffered from a long break in service. Finally, there's a server and the disks that Magento run on, and those also can break. And for example, disks, they have a predefined life cycle, and it's meant to work for like a few years, but they tend to break earlier. I found some statistics on the internet. There was a research being made on more than 60,000 disks for the first quarter of 2016, and in this quarter of the year, 2% of them broke down. And you can see for some models, the failure rate was more than 10% of disks that failed during this time. To show you better the threat, there was a survey being made, and 32% of companies that were surveyed, they said that they have lost data from the cloud. The other research tells us that 20% of companies will suffer loss of critical data every 5 years. So it can happen like 1/5 of this hall, of this room. Why do people lose data? When it comes to regular people, it's mainly because of hardware system malfunction and because of the human error. When it comes to companies, Almost 70% of cases of data loss was because of hacking. It's like the biggest threat for almost every company, hacking. And as we said before, we cannot protect ourselves against it. So we should do backups. Unfortunately, 25% of users don't do backups at all. Another 40% of users, they do it once a year or less. So it's like 2/3 of people that have their backup copies made once a year or less, or none at all. And additionally, more than half of companies don't do daily backups. They have their backup copies that are old. And when you don't have a backup, you will have to face some costs that can be very harmful for you. Those are the costs of data recovery that I found on some Polish website that specializes in data recovery. And you can see that for a one drive, just a single drive, it can go into thousands of dollars to recover data from it. And it can be a very big harm for a small shop, a commerce website. For the bigger ones, there's also another, I think the more important factor, that is the time that is needed to recover the data. It can go for days recovering the data, and if you're a big website and you're in the middle of some advertising campaign, you're losing very, very much money, even more than you lose for just the data recovery. In general, in 2014, it was estimated that the whole industry lost almost $2 trillion because of data loss and downtimes of data centers. And another thing is 60% of companies that lost their critical data, they don't recover. After 6 months, they close, they shut down, and they don't work anymore. So I think we now all agree that we should backup. And how to do it? There is a so-called 3-to-1 rule of backupping. It says you should have at all time at least 3 copies of your data. 2 of them you should store on-site on 2 different devices, and 1 of them you should store somewhere else in a remote location off-site where you do your regular business. And it helps you with 2 things. First, if you lose 1 copy of your data, you still have 2 more to recover from. And if you lose 1 of your locations, you still have another one that you can recover data from and work as you did before. And I would like to tell you a little bit about how we do backups at Centuria. For the start, we do backups on our servers. There's also disks, and we backup to the disks that are in the server. We also have a backup server on site, and we just download the copies of the backups to the backup server. We have a remote location in the data center, and we also have a backup server back then, so we have copies of our data in 2 different data centers. And last but not least is what I would like to tell you a little bit more about, are the offline backups. It's a very simple thing. I think everyone can do it on his own, but not everyone thinks about doing such a thing. And it's a very easy way to keep you safe with backups. And we followed it after the situation with the hosting provider I told you before. It was, we thought, what would happen if someone steals a laptop of our admin, or I don't know, puts a gun at his head and said, delete everything. And we thought that if your data is not connected to any IT infrastructure, no one has access to it, there is almost no chance of you losing it. And that's how we thought that offline backups would be a great thing. And how does it work? Generally, it starts like every regular backup. You've got your server with your data, and you make a backup on a backup server. Then we have another disk that is connected to the server. We download the backup copy and decrypt it. Then we disconnect it so that it's not connected to any infrastructure anymore. We put it into the safe envelope and transport it to the remote location. We have a safe locker and we put it inside. This way, only people who have access to the safe locker have access to your data. If your data is deleted, then you still have one copy that is almost unreachable for any hacker. And how does it work when you want to recover it? We get a call that something is wrong. We double check if the person that is calling us has rights to get the access to the data. We take the backup from the same docker, transport it to the chosen location, connect it to the server, and in even 2 hours we can start recovering data from your disk. And why is this safe? First thing is what I told you about before, is that it is not connected to any IT infrastructure. If someone breaks in, he wouldn't erase your data. And the second thing is that the data is encrypted, so that if someone steals your disk, for example, from transport or something like this, he won't get access to your data because it is encrypted. And I'd like to thank you very much. I think we'll all agree that every day should be your backup day. We should backup, we should do it smart, and if you can, perform offline backups for your data. Thank you. Do you have any questions?
For how long do you keep the offline backups?
It's all agreed with our customer. For example, he wants to keep, like, he wants to make it every week, and he wants to keep 4 copies of this data. Mm-hmm. Then we do it. We have a safe locker, and we just put it. If there's another copy being made, we make it and we erase the other one. It's all agreed with our customer.
Okay, so do you check also drives for corruptions before stealing them into that envelope?
I guess so. I'm not sure because I'm not much of a technical person myself, but I can ask our IT administrators and they can ask.
Because I can see that a hard drive, like a mechanical hard drive, can also be a point of failure.
Yes, it can. Yes, that's true, but it's always better to have more copies than they are stored in a different ways. So
it's checked with MD5 some. MD5 algorithm. After the backup is being done and so the correction is checked. Since we work at the same company, that's why I'm answering.
Thank you, Maciej. Yes?
What is the actual price, say, for the daily offline backup, like copying data and keeping it, driving it somewhere and storing the safe?
You know, we calculated it like this. It costs our people to... it's just a cost of our work being done, so for our smart hands people to connect it, to connect the drive and then to do all those other stuff like put it into the envelope and the transport cost. It's not a big price, I guess. It's like on around 200 zlotys or so for one backup operation. And then we charge our customers with a price for storing their data. Per 1 terabyte. And so those are those 2 prices. The one is for the single backup operation, and the other one is for storing the drives.
Plus the drive store, I guess.
The price of storing the drives includes the price of the drive itself. So it's like... Another questions? So thank you very much.